So here's what my intention is. I want to do a senior series bike, but I want to do it like old school.
Yeah.
So, I mean, really, this is like going back to my roots. I want to do two of these bikes in the vintage style that we've been moving into. A rigid, which we'll build first, and then a swing arm. The designs will be the same. The only difference is the swing arm has rear suspension. You know, I like the look of the rigid better, but the swing arm gives a better ride because of the shocks that absorb the bumps. I think they both appeal to different riders. The question is, do you use a shovel or a pan?
You know, with all the stuff you got here, we can run around and we can look at some motors, we can look at some other stuff here and really get it to where you're like, that's, boom, that's it, you know?
Yeah. So we got everything here. You got knucklehead.
Got all the iconic right motors that you need.
For this bike, I want the motor to be era-specific. The popular motors back in the day were the knucklehead, panhead, and then the shovelhead. There's not a great deal of difference in the performance. I think in the end, it's just about, you know, what your taste is and what the look is. So I think that one will go with the panhead motor.
You don't see very many, you know, bikes that are getting released to the public for sale like that that are pans.
No.
So that's cool. That's unique.
Nobody's making them. You know, I want to sell these bikes, and we're going to sell them right out of the showroom. But my buddy Tom invited me down to Florida to unveil it at an exotic car show. And Florida is a big market for motorcycle sales. So I think it'll be a great place to introduce the bikes to potential customers. Hey, Mike.
What's going on, buddy?
We're talking about.
How are you?
Good. You don't need to give me a hug, all right?
Are these the kind of bikes you used to build before I was... A gleam in your eye, Pappy?
Actually, it was.
Yeah?
If you look like at that bike up there, that was my first Harley.
Yeah.
74 was when you made that bike?
Yeah.
What were you doing before 74?
Drugs.
Okay.
Drugs and alcohol.
What were you doing when you built the bike?
Drugs and alcohol. Today, we're getting started on the raw assembly of the first Senior Series bike, the rigid frame. We got to figure out what works, what looks good.
We got going on here, man.
We got most of the parts, so we got the wheels and the front end and that stuff.
You want me to grab that and drag it over?
Yeah.
Okay.
Get that stuff, yeah. I'm just trying to find a couple different tanks that we can put on there to make sure that we get the look that we want. I think this is too big. So nix that.
Okay. This one's horrendous.
Yeah, this one's bad. Bad. No.
Yeah, that's a hard no.
Let's try that Sportster tank.
Okay, yeah.
And see. Yeah, it's not going to bother. Yeah, I mean, it's cool. We can see what it looks like, which is not too bad. That's too big.
Yeah, it's way too wide,
big.
Right?
That's big.
No shape.
This is cool.
It's better. I mean, it's better than that other one.
It's too high.
Yeah.
It's too much up this way. You know what I mean? It cuts the look of the line, you know?
The mount tabs are kind of, are going to give you a little bit of a headache.
But I just wanted to get the look of it, you know? Of course, Sportster tanks are really, they're
always
cool.
Yeah, absolutely. Classic tank. Yeah.
I don't know. I like this tank because it's a little, it's kind of more like Captain America-ish, you know what I mean? Like, it kind of goes nice with the lines. This is the one I'm thinking.
I really like the
roundness and the, it just.
It's just got a good look,
a
right?
Cool, yeah.
Yeah.
The way it tapers. You know, I really love this part of the building process, trying different parts and trying to achieve the look that I want. Back in the day, it was hard to get a whole specific part, so I would have to take parts and modify them. You know, these days you could find any part, any year that you could possibly want.
Those are right? Those are kind of cool looking.
These got the, I think, 7/8 throttle, the internal throttle.
I don't know that that's a smart move for...
I don't want to deal with that, no. I really like the look of these bars with the internal throttle cable, but I think I'm gonna go with external cables. You know, they're easier to fix. And for the average rider, I want the bike to be simple, easy, and reliable. You like the bar vertical like that? Or?
I like it like that.
Yeah,
but
I do too.
Kind of looks choppery.
I do too.
And it gives it more of an aggressive look to me.
I like that. These are nice, yeah. I like it much better, to be honest with you, much better. So far, I like the decisions that I made for the rigid Senior Series model. The tank, the spokes, the handlebars, the pan end motor, they're all really cool. Now we just need to figure out a million other things. No problem. Yeah, that tank's badass.
I definitely like the shorter risers too, like the handlebars.
Much
to
better.
They
changed
eye.
The whole design, the whole look. Today we're in Florida at the Exotics on Las Olas, and Tom invited us down here to unveil the Senior Series. This is exciting to me because it's, for me, it's something special, something that I've been thinking about for a long time. It's kind of where I came from, so I'm kind of going back to my roots, and we put a lot of time and effort into these bikes, and I hope these bikes will help us reach a whole new group of customers.
Paul Duddle, come on! Paul Sr. from Orange County Choppers. Come on, let's hear it.
OCC, 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 OCC,
what do you guys think? Everybody love the bike? What do you think? I've known Sr. about 3 years, but I've studied his business model since the first day he went into business. I'm super excited for Senior. These are great bikes, man, and I know we've got our first buyers right here.
I'm really proud to announce the new Senior Series. The reason why we did this style bike, because this is what I started off in life with. You know, this goes back to my roots, and this is what I want my legacy to be. Thank you, guys. We're going to start selling the Senior Series bikes out of the OCC showroom, direct to customers. And Tom's going to work on selling bikes down in Florida. You know, it's really been a long journey from where we started from. Everybody always says that they'd someday own one of our bikes, and now they have the opportunity to do that.
Yeah, we got enough bikes for everybody. Step it up. Put your hand in your pocket.
Coming out to
Thanks again for coming out, guys. Thank you.